I'm sure that you know that a feedback suppressor is a device that prevents the unpleasant acoustic feedback that occurs when a sound from a speaker is picked up by a mic and reamplified. In addition to being unpleasant, acoustic feedback places strain on the speakers and can damage them. So to prevent such feedback, the first choice would be to place the speakers so that their sound will not be picked up by the mic and amplified, but this may not be possible. So the second choice would be to use an EQ to locate and remove the offending frequencies. However, remember that these devices are designed to be installed in places where there's no technician with the knowledge to do that. Therefore, we need an automatic solution. In the MTX 3 and MTX 5D, there's a feedback suppressor available on the first 4 and 8 channels respectively. These are notch type feedback suppressors. Let's go and have a demonstration. As we can see from the screen, there are two options, fixed or dynamic. Fixed is best used when the position of the microphone in that channel is fixed or doesn't move. By starting the detect mode and raising the gain to a high point, it will discover and notch out the frequencies that are going to feed back. Let's give you a demonstration of that. I turn the microphone on, the detect mode is on, and as I raise the gain to a higher level, it'll start to discover and notch out those frequencies. As I bring the gain down to a normal level, all of that feedback will be put under control. If you have a microphone that is moving around the building or the room, it's better to use the dynamic mode. This will constantly update any changes in the frequencies that are feeding back as the mic moves through the different points in the axis. Up to 7 dynamic filters are applied at any one time. Depending on the application, it is possible to combine both fixed and dynamic filters simultaneously. Now, the MRX7D also features this same notch-type feedback suppressor, but in addition to that is a pitch shift feedback suppressor component. The pitch shift suppressor acts by pushing the pitch of the detected frequency away from the problem area. And this is perfect for use with moving microphones, as it's constantly learning and correcting the problem frequencies. Let me demonstrate. If I turn this microphone on, and without the feedback suppressor switched on, hold it towards the microphone, we should hear some feedback. Towards the speaker, rather. And I turn the feedback suppressor back on, problem's gone away. Now, it uses a pitch shift algorithm to achieve this, so of course, there is a slight change in sound quality, but this is outweighed by the fact that you can run many of these components at the same time. Up to 8 of the notch type feedback suppressors can be run simultaneously in MRX7D, but when it comes to the pitch shift component, many more instances can be used depending on your need and the DSP resource. And as a little tip, if you're experiencing feedback problems that cannot be solved with speaker or microphone placement, it is possible to connect a notch feedback suppressor and pitch shift feedback suppressor in series. And this will give you around 3 dB extra gain before feedback.